You're wearing the wrong t-shirt. What do you doing?
Yes, I've never been to a Comic-Con, and I'm a lifelong Superman fan.
Yes.
So, I mean, if I had ever come to a Comic-Con before today, it would have been in a Superman costume.
Nice.
So I figured
it's still
awesome.
Time. There's still time.
It's my tattoo, Superman. I love
there
him.
You go. What's the appeal of this character for you? I mean, how do you see him, and what's the appeal?
He's just so, I mean, he's full of hope and optimism, which is, like, easily relatable for everyone, I think, or everyone would like to have those aspects, I think, those qualities. And I think I kind of always have, I think to stay sane in this business, some optimism is necessary, so I relate to that for sure. And he's just so sweet. I've played so many characters that, like, I would never be friends with or wouldn't want to be in the same room with. So it's nice to play somebody that people like.
In a strange way, Barry Allen, Grant Gustin plays Barry Allen. Even though Barry Allen is like an ordinary guy with extraordinary powers, in many ways, he's the most easily defined character for us on screen. There's 80 plus years of mythology we can tap into. We sort of know what he wants and where he's going. Whereas a number of us, myself included, you know, like any good comic book, are operating on a few different levels. Now, those levels are something that, you know, essentially sold me on the show. And I've done a couple of shows with Andrew and Greg Berlanti. And they have delivered every time we've gotten together. So when they talked about this one, I was like, they kind of shut the door and kind of like laid out the show for me, and I was like, oh yeah, I'm in.
Well, I play Detective Joe West, who works at the Central City Police Department. I have also helped raise little Barry Allen into the man he's become today, because his father obviously is incarcerated.
I know, obviously, you're part of the Team Flash.
Yes.
As a scientist.
Team Flash.
As a female scientist,
I love it.
You know, et cetera. So what do you feel that you're bringing to the Team Flash?
It's such a unique perspective. Yeah. You know, it's great to have a woman on board, a really smart woman. And, you know, she does also bring that sort of emotional, sensitive perspective to things, too. She is, from the very beginning, so concerned about Barry and him getting hurt. And very, you know, especially after the trauma she went through losing her fiancé in the explosion, she wants to make sure he's okay.
You know, when I first found out I'd play his father, I looked at Arrow because I wanted to see how he worked. You know, and I was relieved to see that he's really sincere. There's no acting. I don't know what he was pulling on when he was talking about his dad, but it was simple, it was honest, it had energy, and it wasn't acting. And that's the most important thing, you know, the acting book, no acting, please. You know, it was very real. And then we did the scene in the prison together. And I thought, this kid has chops. And Jesse said it best. He said, this show is going to work. If it works for one reason, it's because that guy's head and his heart are in alignment and they're in the right place.
You know, obviously on Arrow, especially early on, it was meant to be very grounded and whatnot. And part of the reason we introduced the Mirakuru storyline last year with Slade and the Human Weapons was, you know, for us it was a little bit of like gateway superpowers. You know, if you could accept that much, well then you could accept the Flash. And it was really Greg's idea that, you know, we also include the particle accelerator, because then you understand where all of these villains came from, and you didn't have this one seminal event make him, but then have to have a seminal event make all of these other people. You know, now these people are sort of out there. You know, it does allow you to, you know, push the boundaries certainly far further than we ever did or will on Arrow.
Yeah.
Are there any particular powers from the comics that you really hope they get to pretty quickly?
Yeah, I hope we start to incorporate, I mean, it's been teased already, but I hope we start to incorporate some time travel, like, sooner rather than later. Because I think it just presents a lot of fun storylines.
Sure, yeah.
And it was one of the things I think Smallville did really well, in that, you know, Clark didn't have his full capabilities, and especially I always think about the episode where he first got heat vision. It wasn't a cool thing. He was terrified that he'd be looking at Lana and he would melt her, and he started to, like, fear that, like, am I going to have to go live in a cabin in the woods by myself? And I found that so heartbreaking. And I think that, you know, for the Flash, you know, in the comics, you know, being able to travel through time and phase through matter, like, it does start to become this, like, godlike ability that, like, it would be hard for anyone to ever sort of, like, you know, bring him down. So we're going to try and keep it, you know, at least early on, you know, as limited as we can.
These guys, you know, Andrew and Greg and Jeff, have no interest in sort of copying what they've done. In the first 9 episodes alone, there's an extremely fearless brand to what they're doing. To the point where I said to Greg, I'm like, we are all worried about being able to regenerate story because we are getting so much. If you are a fan of this kind of thing, I tell you, The Flash, the first 9 in The Flash is just like, boom, boom, boom. Things that you might think you want to keep in your quiver. No, they're firing those things off in a hurry. And we're kind of like reading the scripts going, what? Wow, already? Wow. You know, and I said to Greg, are you, we'd all concerned about story. Quote, he's like, always more story.
And what I'm moving in now in the scripts is, what's going on with you? You know? And we walked that ambiguous line after our first time I'm confronted with Flash. Does Henry know, does he? And that changes my motivation. I get out of the maudlin, you know, changes my whole motivation. Meisner would be very proud. It takes all of the attention off of me and puts it on him. So even when I'm telling a story, what I'm really doing is looking for any sign of, you know, anything that he might give away about what's up with him. Is he waiting for him to tell me? If indeed he is, if indeed I even suspect it. So playing an ambiguity specifically, I don't know, we'll see how it works out. You'll tell me.
And I've read a lot of the comics since I got the role. I tried to start at the beginning, and then I realized that wasn't going to be possible to like read all the way through. So I'm reading the new 52 series just because I think it's the closest to what we're creating.
One of the things I told Andrew Kreisberg, Jeff Johns, and Greg Berlanti is, you know, they're all so knowledgeable about this comic world, you know, who the metahumans are, who's coming, what this means, you know, why that gorilla cage is all smashed up. And I had to tell him to stop. I was like, stop telling me stuff, because I don't want to know. And I don't think Joe West knows any of this stuff, so I want to learn it as it comes. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, I know Wentworth Miller is coming, and I know him, he's a great actor, but I don't know what he's playing. I just want to walk on set and see him and be like, oh, you know, I don't want to know too much.
For the first time, we'll be next week on set with Barry as Flash. And when I was reading that, that felt, if it's going to happen, if there's going to be a sense of displacement, it's going to happen then. But it remains to be seen. You know, the story is so different. The character is so much darker. I can't imagine Emmett Walsh killing Priscilla Pointer. You know what I mean? And ending up in prison. I can't imagine Emmett Walsh, my dad killed my mom. What?
The uniform changed? Yeah. We made it like, first of all, it's like the one in the pilot is, I'm glad it's not, the spandex, first of all. But the one in the pilot we had was, I loved it, but it was really heavy. And we've made it like 10 pounds lighter since the pilot. So I love the suit now. I was in it for 13 hours the other day and it was fine. I mean, it's actually pretty comfy.
From, you know, sort of the beginning, see the relationship between she and Barry. And, you know, I think that friendship will grow. They have they can relate to having lost someone. And, you know, that grief that you sort of carry around with you. And I think there's a kindred spirit in there.
The kindred spirit, will that lead to relationship? Perhaps.
I think it definitely could.
Mm-hmm, okay.
Hopefully we've got a long series to figure all that out. Everybody loves a good love triangle.
Sure. You know, we'll never have a show, especially early on, where people are like, oh yeah, guy's flying. You know, been there, done that. I mean, this isn't Metropolis. It's, you know, these things are all happening for the first time, and there's going to be people who are skeptical about it and people who are afraid of it, and, you know, hopefully that realistic reaction will make it feel like it's still in the world of Arrow, even if more miraculous things are happening.